So the breatharian journey, I've actually not had a breatharian on the show, I think, in all the years I've been doing this, except for one European girl who reached out to me a few years ago. But her accent was so thick that it was actually hard to understand her. So we didn't get it together, but I'd love to explore the breatharian journey because I know that many people in the mainstream collective consciousness debunk it. Oh, that's impossible. Oh, people are lying. Oh, that's impossible. Scientists and doctors come out and they say, no, this is impossible. This is how the structure works. But of course, science, the mainstream science, doesn't introduce that divine journey or the consciousness journey or the energy journey. You know, they're looking at molecules instead of atoms, I suspect.
Yes.
When did it start for you? When did you decide that this is what you wanted to be, display?
I didn't. It was a shock, you know, because when my body shifted naturally into this, I was just interested in the ascension journey. You know, that's all I was interested in, this up-leveling that we had begun to go into after the harmonic convergence in 1987, you know, where millions of people got together and they took advantage of that energy time to meditate and just ask for an up-leveling of our world so that the political, economic, health structures, social structures, educational systems, all of it could up level so that it operated for the highest good of all. And that was a huge prayer that many have recognized and focused on. It's like, come on, let's lift it up. Come on, we can do better. Because you do have this beta frequency brainwave pattern that is a hologram where everything you just said is so true. It's impossible to be nourished in this way when your dominant frequency is left brain, patriarchal, duality based, beta brainwave frequency that doesn't even recognize the divine feminine, that doesn't even recognize that the core frequency we can all access that really feeds us and will heal us is unconditional love. In the other realms, in the other frequency zones, the food there is just unconditional love. There's no judgment. It's like, ooh, how are you going in your life on earth? It's like, it's really hard being human. And then there's a lot of laughter and yeah, well, you knew that going in. It's like, yeah, but I didn't realize it would be this difficult because the dominant frequency of the masses is not vibing in unconditional love. It's vibing in fear, or it's vibing in that's impossible. And it's like, yes, that is impossible if you're in this mindset and if you're in this frequency. But if you can do what people have been doing for thousands and thousands of years, and that is just let it go. Just let it all go. Just drop back in, relax back into another part of you that is infinite love and infinite peace and infinite awareness. And in that love and in that peace is all the guidance, all the answers to your questions, all the power, all the, oh, now I'm home.